Hello friends and welcome to Digimento. Today we will be taking up Sushant Singh Rajput case and the CBI. Recently, CBI has taken over the case of Sushant Singh Rajput. So to probe into the cause of death, this has been taken by CBI. So today we will be discussing about some of the important facts related to this case, and also in detail we will see CBI as an organization. So let's begin the lecture. But before that, if you have not yet subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe to our channel. Also, do share this video with your friends if you like the video. And let's start. Okay. So, first of all, let us come to some of the facts related to Sushant Singh Rajput. So, he is an Indian actor. So, he was an Indian actor who was best known for his work in Hindi cinema. So, he mostly starred in Hindi movies. And he was personally one of my favorite, and also for many of you he would have been one among the favorites. I'm sure about it. And it was also very sad news to hear that he was dead. Okay, so Rajput started his career with television serials. He acted in a number of serials, and this was his entry into the movie industry. So this is how he entered the movie industry. Then these are some of the famous movies that he starred in. So these are some of the very famous, and among that one of my personal favorite was MS Dhoni. And MS Dhoni still remains one of the personal favorites for many of you. So MS Dhoni, The Untold Story, then Kedarnath, Chichor. So all these movies are like ever time favorites. And his last film was Dil Bechara. So these are some facts about Sushant Singh Rajput. And Rajput died by suicide at his home in Bandra in Mumbai in the month of June. Now let's come to CBI. Now we all must be knowing about this case and about Sushant Singh Rajput and all, but today our focus will remain on studying or learning about CBI, the Central Bureau of Investigation, which will be handling the case now. So let's discuss about CBI in detail. Let's see all the important facts and background, and also the scope of CBI, in which areas can CBI conduct the investigation, and what are the shortcomings or the challenges in CBI as an organization. So all these we will be discussing in detail today. So first of all, CBI is the premier investigating police agency in India. So premier means that one of the most important, the significant investigating agency, investigating police agency. So investigating police agency, which investigates or probes into various cases. The functions of the CBI, it's conducted or it is carried out under the superintendence of Ministry of Personnel, Pension and Public Grievances. So the CBI, it functions under the Ministry of Personnel, Pensions and Public Grievances, and it is the nodal police agency in India which coordinates investigation on behalf of Interpol member countries. Now what is Interpol? Interpol is international police. So Interpol is international police, and CBI represents India at the Interpol or in the international police. So it is a nodal police agency in India which coordinates investigation on behalf of Interpol member countries. So this is very, very important. Okay. So CBI has such a significance that it is the nodal police agency which coordinates investigation on behalf of the Interpol member countries. And now let's know a little bit about the historical background of CBI. How did CBI come up? So we will see some of the important historical facts related to CBI. How did it come up? During the period of World War II, during World War II, a special police establishment was constituted in 1941. So during the Second World War, a special police establishment was constituted. Now here you must understand that during the World War II, we were under the colonial rule of the British. So we were a colony of British. We were not independent. It was in 1947 that we became independent. So during the Second World War, during those period, we were under the British rule, British administration, we were a colony of British. So 1941, a special police establishment was constituted. Later on, this special police establishment, that is SPE, it was formalized as an agency of the Government of India to investigate into allegations of corruption in various wings of the Government of India. So later on, the scope and the importance of the SPE, the Special Police Establishment, became that it became an agency of the Government of India to investigate into, to probe into the allegations of corruption. So corruption related offenses or corruption related allegations were investigated by this special police establishment, corruption in various wings of the government, various departments, various ministries, various wings of the Government of India. The investigation was carried out by this special police establishment. Now, the CBI, it derives powers to investigate from the Delhi Special Police Establishment Act of 1946. So, Delhi Special Police Establishment Act. So, this act provides powers to CBI to investigate into certain matters. Now, this is an act passed in 1946. Okay. So, again, this is before the independence. Now, the CBI, it derives powers to investigate from this particular act, which is the Delhi Special Police Establishment Act. In 1963, the CBI was established by the Government of India with a view to investigate serious crimes. So, this is after independence, that is in 1963, post-independence, CBI, that is earlier, as we said, we had SPE, Special Police Establishment, then this SPE was formalized again. Then in 1963, that is post-independence, that is the Government of India, the government established CBI as an investigating agency to look into serious crimes. So 1963, CBI was established by the Government of India with a view to investigate serious crimes. So even though the name was SPE or Special Police Establishment, we can trace the background or we can trace the beginning of CBI with that of British administration in India. Later the name was changed to CBI. Now let's see what are the kind of cases that are handled by CBI. This will also give us an information about what is the scope of functioning of CBI. So scope of functioning. Okay. First one is anti-corruption crimes. So basically CBI was established in order to look into anti-corruption crimes or crimes related with corruption. So this is one of the most important role assumed by CBI, to look into corruption related crimes. Second one is economic crimes. Economic crimes means that crimes which are related to money related crimes and which affects the economic system. Third one, crimes of special nature or special crimes. And fourth one is very important, suo moto cases. What is meant by suo moto? Suo moto means that CBI itself, that is CBI itself, can take the initiative to take up the investigation of certain crimes. So here in case of suo moto cases, CBI can suo moto take up investigation of offenses, but only in the union territories. Why only in union territories? This is because the UTs or the union territories come under the direct control and the administrative capacity of the central government. CBI being a central government authority or central government organization, it's a central authority. So CBI being a central authority, it can suo moto or by its own initiative take up the investigation of those crimes and offenses in union territories. And again, the central government can authorize the CBI to investigate a crime in a state, but only with the consent of the concerned state government. So the central government can authorize CBI to take up the investigation of any crime in any state. Suo moto is done only in case of union territory. Now, central government can authorize the CBI to look into certain investigations or crimes in states, but only with the consent of the concerned state government. Now, the Supreme Court and the High Court, however, can order CBI to investigate a crime anywhere in the country without the consent of the state. Now, this is important that the central government can authorize the CBI to take up the investigation in certain states, but here what is needed? The consent of the state government is needed. Whereas the Supreme Court, the apex court, or the High Court of any state. So High Court and Supreme Court can order the CBI to look into any of the cases without the consent of the state government. So this is again very important. Now let's also discuss about some of the challenges, the contemporary challenges that the CBI faces. So these are some of the challenges faced by CBI. First one is excessive political interference. So as any other organization, the political interference is very high in CBI also. There are enormous delays in concluding the investigations. That is the time lag. Why? Because most of the times what happens is that CBI is a central authority. It is appointed by the central government. Whereas when the cases are taken up or investigated in the state governments, even though the states give the consent, they sometimes do not cooperate. The state machinery or the state administration does not properly coordinate and also cooperate with the CBI. So this has led to delay in the investigation or the time lag in the investigation. So this is another issue. And over a period of time, CBI has also lost its credibility largely due to the time lag. So time lag or the time taken for concluding the cases, and also the problem of accountability, that CBI is not to a larger extent accountable to the authority or to the legislature. So this has also created issues within CBI, and there is also an acute shortage of personnel. The manpower or the human resource is inadequate in the CBI to carry out the investigation and related issues. Then CBI also has limited powers and restricted access. So these are some of the problems that are faced by CBI in the contemporary times. So this is all about the CBI as an organization, as a central authority. And because this was in the current affair recently, I thought of discussing this with you. Again, I would like to remind you, if you have not yet subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe and share this video with your friends. Thank you.